Hey there.
Hi there.
Hello there, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Laxin' with Lurchy, where the pigs seem to be going a little stir-crazy over there. Y'all right, bud? You know that's a drinking water, not a dancing water, right? Oh, he pushed him right off, said, hold on, man, it's my turn. Oh, man, you know, I bet they're a little cooped up over there, which, honestly, I can kind of relate to. See, I've also been feeling a little cooped up recently. I don't know if it's because we spent all that time in the deep dark last episode, or if it's because we've been putting in a lot of work into this town, being in the same area. But regardless, I had to fix it. So, I went out there, and like the brave knight that I am, I went and I conquered a bunch of ruins, and I did a bunch of brushing, and we got ourselves a good little bit of goodies. But before I show you guys those goodies, we're going to go ahead and watch a montage of me being a very knightly knight, a very heroic knight. I don't mean to flex on you too hard, but I think Knight of the Year award is in my future. Oh, I'm just teasing. But what'd you guys think? Man, we went through so many different kind of ruins. We made sure to hit them all. We've got the cold ocean, the warm ocean. We went to the desert. We went to the jungle. The only ruin that I could not find that saddens me so is a trail ruin. I have yet to find a trail ruin, but I will, for I am Sir Lurchy Lurch, and I am a brave knight who finds things and brushes them off, because that is what brave knights do. But anyways, this right here, this is all the different looty we got. Let me rephrase. These three right here is all the different looty we got. So in the chest at all the different ruins that we got, we got a whole bunch of buried treasure maps. Now, I'm sure a couple of these lead to the same area. Like, you know, a couple of these, I found two of them in the same boat. So I wouldn't be surprised if some of these go to the same spot. But we've got the potential for a whole lot of adventure right there. Then we picked up a couple of random goodies. The Nautilus shells I'm pretty excited about. I would like a conduit at some point. And we found a few diamonds, some gold, golden apples. Nothing super crazy out of the chest, right? Then while we were out and about, I did find a coral reef, so I made sure to grab a whole bunch of the fans, some coral itself. At one point, I needed to repair my elytra. So we went ahead and got our meat stock back up a little bit. Now this one, right here, actually has all of the 120 stuff in it. So let's go ahead and crack this baby open. Oh, look at that. We got 12 of the different shards and a bunch of duplicates of some of them. I'm pretty excited for the different pots and stuff we're going to be able to do. We'll have to think of some cool ways to display our brave heroism. Heroics. So something like that. Then we got ourselves 2 sniffer eggs. This was initially what I set out for. I really wanted to get some sniffers, and I was dead set that I wasn't coming home until I got at least 2 of them. So we did. We got 2 of them. Then we got a couple smithing templates, which I'm pretty excited about. We might end up putting this on our armor at some point today after we duplicate them. I'm not 100% sure what the recipe is for duplicating, so I'll have to, either try and guess it or look it up or something, I don't know. But we'll figure that out. And these are just leftover brushes. But yeah, you guys, that is all the loot we got. Man, oh man. I am excited for those pottery shards. I'm excited for the snippers. I've actually got an idea for a cool little snipper farm. Nothing super complicated or anything. I don't fully understand the mechanics of how they work, but I've got a cool idea for a farm that I think we're going to do right over in that area at some point. But that is not what we're going to be doing today. Now, you see, I have a plan today. See, we still have 2 days to complete the task that the wizard wants us to do. If we come over here, we'll brush up on it. Because I know he wanted us to do the bottom of this tower. And ooh, buddy, did we finish the bottom of this tower. I am super happy with how this came out. Oh, yeah. Look at this. The skulk and the black concrete. The purple highlights here and this floor. Ooh, buddy. I went to town on this floor. I wanted it to be a very intricate floor. And yeah, I think that dude Browski the Excellent is going to be very happy with this. But let's go ahead and hop in this book real quick. And let's see, I think it's right here. Please make ready the bottom half of the tower and a constant supply of blaze powder for his potion brewing. So, we need to do a blaze farm. But, like I said, we still have 2 days until he shows up. I think right here in our immediate future, we need to make a farm to get more of these bad boys, more rockets. We've already got our creeper farm. I did a little touching up with the design, made it a little more efficient, but that's all we have right now. We don't have a sugarcane farm, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go ahead and do a sugarcane farm, but we're not gonna do a small one like we did on our bamboo, where it's just the observers and pistons. Oh no. We're going all out. We're doing a flying machine sugarcane farm. So, the other shulker has everything we need for it. They're not super complicated, they're just rather large, so it's a lot of blocks to place. But I'm gonna go ahead and go grab that shulker, and then we're gonna head over to where I wanna put it. Let's see, let's hop over here. Let's pick all of these up. You know what? Those ones will be fine right there for now. We don't need them immediately. So, right in here is kind of where I'm thinking I want to put the sniffer farm. I think I built it so that I believe aesthetically it'll fit in with our stable, which I just realized I don't think I've shown you guys either. Oh, I'm awful. This is our stable. Look at all of the animals we have. We have all of our llamas, horses. We got donkeys. You guys, we got donkeys. Look, I can ride a donkey. Look at me. Oh, I'm so happy right now. Oh, I love his ears. I love his little ears. Oh, but we're getting sidetracked. We are getting sidetracked and we're going a little crazy. All right, so yeah, we got our stable up. It's pretty nice. I like it. It's mostly just food storage. They can come in here, you know, if it's really raining, but they don't seem to mind the rain. It's raining right now and they're out here. But yeah. Oh man, this area is looking pretty good. And like I said, I think that this sniffer farm will fit in perfectly in this area. But the sugarcane farm, I'm kind of thinking I want over here, right? We're going to have the flying machine. We'll go ahead and we'll probably do some terraforming right here. Probably extend out our custom forest that we're doing a little ways. And then have the flying machine set up right here. And we'll probably set it up on a day-night cycle so that it only harvests really twice a day. But I think that'll be plenty. With the size that we're going for, that'll be more than enough rockets for just us. But let's go ahead and I'm going to get right into this and start building it. Okay, so we've got it all built up. Look at that. We're going to start getting sugarcane super fast. So I kind of wanted to go over this a little bit with you, explain a little bit of it. We have right here all of these different stone sections are our stopping minecart because they have stuff in them and wait till they're fully unloaded circuits. And I think we have 6 minecarts altogether. The minecarts run directly underneath where the sugarcane is, not underneath the leaves. The leaves actually just cover the water and make it so that sugarcane can't get over there. The flying machine runs right along top the leaves, and since leaves are unmovable, they don't move. And any sugarcane that lands on them, the flying machine pushes. Now, we do lose a little sugarcane in these holes on either side. We probably could have extended the glass out and did the waterway a little different. But I didn't want some huge crazy footprint here. I do want to be able to put some form of building or gazebo or something like that around this. So I wanted the smallest footprint that I possibly could. Then we've got these circuits. We've got one on either side, and these are the send-off circuits. This is just a day-night sensor that goes into a monostable circuit. So whenever it turns day, obviously it gives out a constant signal the whole time it's day. But because of our monostable circuit, as soon as it turns day, it sends the one signal through that sends the flying machine to the other side. And then this stays up, so it's not going to send another signal through until this powers down and repowers up tomorrow morning. And we've got the same thing on the other side. It's just set up for the night cycle, so it'll send it back over there as soon as it turns night. Then right here we have our auto dropping system. All of this, everything that the mine carts and the waterways collect, come through here to our droppers, which gets sent down the stream under here that we can kind of see. They come into these chests, and if you look at that. We've already almost got enough to make 3 full sets of rockets, or 2 full sets. Yeah, 2 full sets, because it takes 3 for paper. I don't know. Math isn't my strong suit. But yeah, guys, this is it. We've got it all done. It's not decorated yet, but it is in. Oh, and look, we're going to get a watch it go. See, and look, we'll see a little bit of what I'm talking about when it comes to losing some of it. Oh, and then of course that time we didn't lose a single piece. Oh man, you know what? That's okay though. That's ultimately what we want. But yeah, we've got that going. We did a little terraforming over here. We haven't extended the forest yet, but I'm kind of debating on putting like a little pond right here. I'm not sure yet. If we did some kind of little pond, I was thinking maybe we just do the whole river and run it all down through here. But, like I said, I'm not 100% sure yet. So, now that we've got this done, I think that it might be high time we start working on our next quest for Mr. Dude Browski. We probably ought to go ahead and head down to the Nether and get set up over there where we found that double blaze spawner in our fortress. Now, I don't know if I've ever told you guys this. Man, oh man, I am... Oh! I'm not a fan of this place, and this is why! This is exactly why! Oh no, oh no. Okay, get a little fire resist. Man, this place is absolutely insane. But, we are over here at our fortress that we found. And if we look here, we can see... Boom! There is our double spawner. Now, it's really nice, because they really are super close together. It's going to make building this really easy. So, with that, I think I'm going to go ahead and get this dug out, see what kind of room we're working with. I haven't done any testing on this farm. We're going to be doing this all together. So, like I said, let's go ahead and start this and see what happens. And indeed, we have done some digging. We look, we have right down there. This is where all the blaze will end up. We've already got a couple over here. That's because we've got this one side all the way set up, this side. Got it all dug out, all full of its lava and whatnot. Man, these guys are louder than crap. Let's see if we can't get in here and finish setting this up. See how long our fire resist is going to be good for. Golly, this is, see, this is what this has been. Who needs a farm? We got this. I just come here and kill these guys. I've already got like 4 or 5 stacks of blaze rods. But the wizard says he needs a constant supply. So a constant supply is what we're going to give him. So let's go ahead. And as you can see, we've dug out our 9x9 area. Oh, this is getting hot and heavy. We've dug out our 9x9 area. And right here along the front, we have our trench that will end up pushing them all over here. They're very simple. Blaze farms... Okay. This blaze farm is very simple. It was mostly digging. Use lava to push them around. Nothing crazy. There's really no redstone. The hoppers going into a chest, that's our collection system. It's super easy. I mean, look at all these guys here already. This is only with one side set up. Man, oh man, these guys are loud as crap. Let's see if we can't go ahead and... Oh, that was the wrong one. Let's see if we can't go ahead and change these hostile creatures. Turn you guys down a bit. Good gracious. But yeah, we've got this all set up, all done. I need to get the lava in on that side, which is probably going to take me a second. I almost died when I did this side. I mean, if we want, we can take a peek in here just to see. Like, we've got the lava that pushes them all into the trench, and the trench pushes them that way. So, we're going to do the same thing on this side, and then we'll be back. And now that both sides are complete, we are getting quite the flow of these guys. This double spawner farm is going to do us some good. We will have more than a constant supply of blaze powder for Dude Browski. Oh man, I am not at all excited to be in the Nether, but I am very excited that this is done. This will not only help Dude Browski fight off that evil creature, but this will also help us. We like to brew potions too, so having some blaze powder will help us a lot too. With all that being said, I'm tired of this place. I want to go home. So let's do that. Alrighty, we are finally back in the beautiful overworld. But you guys, I'm not feeling so good. See, I had a bit of an incident on the way out. Get that. Slain by a magma cube. Oh, how embarrassing. We did manage to get back and get all our stuff, but I am just still not feeling so great. I think that magma cube did something to me. Oh no, it's turning us into a wither skeleton. Oh, I'm just teasing. We just happened to find a wither skeleton skull on the way out. So that's pretty nice. We just need, what, two more? And we can get a whole nother beacon, which is definitely something I would like to do fairly soon. We have our one beacon over there in the hole that I'm digging that I believe to be a slime chunk. I haven't really shown you guys because, well, I don't know if it's a slime chunk. There's no point in showing you guys just a giant hole. Those are all over the place. But here in the next couple episodes, we are definitely going to be doing something with that area over there. But yeah, more beacons. That would be nice. We've got to get two more skulls and then we can get a whole nother beacon. Which, yeah, like I've said, 95 million times in the last 30 seconds. That'll be awesome. But with that, I think that we are going to end today's episode with a little bit of a song. A little bit of Other Side by Lena Rain. Man, oh man, guys, it sure has been a fun episode. We got a whole lot done today. We got our flying machine sugarcane farm done. We got our double blaze spawner blaze farm done, which will bring in plenty of blaze powder. I think that will constitute as a constant flow for Mr. Dude Browski the Wizard whenever he shows up, which hopefully should be in the next couple days. That's what his note said anyway. I'm pretty excited for him to show up. I'm very curious what he's going to be doing to fight off that evil creature and what help he's going to need from us. Well, it is a curiosity that we cannot quite scratch yet, but I'm very excited. I'm sure that we have some action-packed episodes ahead of us. So you guys, if you guys like this episode, don't forget to leave a like on the episode. And if you really liked it, don't forget to subscribe. And we'll see you guys next time. Thanks, everybody. Bye-bye.